So, tell us what are you doing currently?
Sir, presently I am working as assistant agriculture officer under district agriculture officer Khariar in Nuakhara district, sir.
In Nuakhara district.
Yes, sir.
And what are the responsibilities that the agriculture assistant agriculture officer has?
Sir, basically extension of technology, newly developed agricultural technology, the responsibility of an assistant agriculture officer through subordinated staffs like village agriculture workers and agriculture overseers.
So, in the district in which you are currently posted, can you tell me particularly what is, what are your particular responsibilities?
Sir, in Nuakhara district, land holding capacity is very small and dissemination of new developed technologies is not so easy like coastal areas. So, motivation to the farmers is basic challenge for a assistant agriculture officer and farm mechanization, adoption of new varieties, these are the main challenges of a assistant agriculture officer in Nuakhara district, sir.
So, what is the main problem for the farmers? Why they are not adopting new technology? The lack of awareness, or they are not able to get the finance?
Sir, first of all, it is lack of awareness, and after that, Nuakhara district land holding capacity is very small, and farmers are not so not so capable to purchase the high cost machinery for mechanization of the farming system. So,
You can name any two government programs which you are implementing, both of the state government and the central government, related to agriculture.
sir, National Food Security Mission, it is a state along with central sponsored scheme in which all inputs are supplied to the farmers for adoption of the new technologies like seeds, input chemicals like pesticides and herbicides along with micronutrients, sir. It is basically implemented for land transplanting and system of rice intensification.
And this is one, National Food Security Mission, and
And another is, sir, improved package of practices in which land transplanting of paddy is basically emphasized and land transplanting of pulses, bheri, moong, etc., sir.
So, can you tell me what is the percentage of land under cultivation in Odisha and also in the district in which you are there?
Sir, sorry, sir, I don't
Approximately.
clearly get. In Odisha, it is 68%.
Near about 68%.
Near about 68%.
What are the major crops which are grown in Nuwapada?
In Nuwapada district, sir, main crop is paddy. After harvest of paddy, they are growing bheri and moong, and in along with paddy in the hilly area, cotton is also in some part. Cotton is also growing, and sweet corn also.
So, what is the terrain in your district, in Nuwapada? What is the terrain? It is plain or it is hilly or?
It is basically hilly area, sir.
And what also this is about, this crops, food crops and all. And what about commercial crops and horticulture that is also practiced there? Vegetables, flowers, you have some.
Sir, flowers are not there, but vegetables are cultivating there. In commercial crops, cotton is the main crop in that area. nearby block, Komna and Khariar block are famous for cotton cultivation in Nuwakhai district as well as in Odisha, sir.
Okay. So this is your first posting or earlier you were in other places also?
In agriculture department, this is my first posting, sir. I have there since September 2015 and before that I was in bank, sir.
You were in the bank, you were working as bank?
Yes, sir.
As what?
In Union Bank of India, sir.
As a probationary officer or?
As a rural development officer, sir.
Rural development officer?
Yes, sir.
So, why did you leave that job and you came to agriculture?
Sir, as agriculture is my prime course and and I was also posted at Ajamgarh, one of the district in Uttar Pradesh.
Oh, okay.
And which is far away from my native place.
And
there is some problem in my family to look after the parents.
You were there in Ajamgarh for how many years?
Yes, 3 years, sir.
3 years you were there?
Yes,
in Ajamgarh?
Yes, sir.
Can you give us an insight about the socio-economic conditions of that district, because that district is in news always for all the wrong reasons. Can you tell us something?
Yes, sir. In Ajamgarh district, there is Muslim population is more than Hindus.
Mm-hmm.
And that's why always there is a dispute among Hindus and Muslims.
Communal problems.
Communal problems there.
Now, as a banker, what problems you faced?
Sir, in my 3 years I stay there, basically there is no major problem.
So you were basically in an RRB, right? Regional Rural Bank?
No, sir.
Huh?
It is a public sector bank, sir. Union Bank of India.
Okay, in Union Bank of India, you were there as a regional development officer.
Rural development.
Rural development officer.
Yes, sir.
So, what is the main work of a rural development officer?
At Union Bank of India is in Eastern UP. Union Bank is lead bank, sir.
Okay.
And so it is our prime duty to develop the agriculture sector, as it is plain Gangetic area also. Eastern UP is plain Gangetic area. So it is very fertile land, and I am always trying to finance the agriculture sector as much as possible.
There, what are the major crops?
Sir, sugar cane, paddy, wheat, these are the main crops, sir.
Yes, sir.
Okay,
fine. So, now you want to come to administration. All the posts which are there, they are basically administrative posts?
Yes, sir.
So, what is the reason? You are already in a domain area, you know, where you will utilize your knowledge. So, and what is the reason you want to join the civil services? Now you are in a specialized service. That is basically for your entire life you will work in the field of agricultural development. That is something which you have studied. If you are coming into civil service, you will become a generalist. You have to work in many situations, especially if you go for administrative service. Today you will be in law and order, tomorrow you will be in institutional development, okay, tomorrow you will be in public sector enterprise. So you will be basically like a rolling stone. Okay, so you must have heard rolling stone gathers no moss.
Yes.
Okay, it would be something like that. So what would be your counter to my proposition that if you become a generalist you will be doing something of different work? Okay, different types of work in your entire lifetime.
Yes.
So, how will that benefit you and also benefit the society?
Yes, sir. First of all, sir, in 2000, OCS exam 2016, these all three posts are class 1 course, and I am now posted in class 2 course, sir. And after joining in the civil services, I will utilize my knowledge for betterment of all sectors. And in my present posting, I am only working for the farming community. And as I will be a civil servant, I will always try to disseminate my knowledge to the farming community as well as all sectors of the society. Civil service plays a vital role for development of economic development of our society as well as our state and country. So my specialized knowledge also helps the administration for necessary action and necessary advice to the farming community.
Okay. So, what are your service preferences that you have chosen?
Sir, my first preference is Odisha Finance Service, second is Odisha Administrative Service, and third is Odisha Police Service, sir.
So, you have first taken Odisha Finance Service?
Yes, sir.
Why? What is the reason? Most of the candidates they generally prefer administrative service. Why you have taken finance service?
Sir, I was in finance sector, so little bit I have interest in finance sector. And also, financial administration also plays a vital role for development of the economy. So I have chosen the Odisha Financial Service, sir, before Odisha Administrative Service.
Okay, what is the career progression of Odisha Finance Service, can you tell me?
Sir, after selecting a candidate in OPSC through common recruitment process, he will be posted at junior batch officer after 10 years of service. He will be promoted to senior batch, and after 15 years he will be a
What is the highest post that you can go to?
Sir, highest post is special secretary, sir.
Special secretary, okay. Okay. And you must have heard recently that there was an attack on the house of a bureaucrat.
Yes,
know,
sir.
Sir.
Yes, sir.
So, can you tell me what is the reason that not the reason, you can tell me, apart from these things, once you become a public servant, a civil servant,
yes, sir.
What are the occupational hazards that you will face? According to you, what are the most, what are the occupational hazards that you will face?
Sir, first of all, it is, occupational hazards are, as we cannot satisfy everyone, so some people may not be satisfied in our day-to-day work and satisfying their egos and also their work. So these people may harm in our family life as well as in day-to-day life.
Okay. So recently there has been a major international political situation,
yes,
in a nearby country, neighboring country.
Yes.
Can you tell me which country I am talking about?
Sir, it is Maldives.
Maldives, right.
Yes, sir.
Why Maldives is important for India, and till now what has been the stance of India in this crisis? And you can tell me for 1 minute about the crisis, what has happened actually?
Sir, in Maldives, some political leaders are arrested and arrested as per the order of the president.
Okay, then?
And civilians want they should not be arrested.
Okay.
And this is the main reason for
unrest.
Unrest, sir.
What is India's position? What till now? What has India done with?
India is talking with our neighboring countries and also with USA, China, for controlling the situation there.
Okay. So tell me one thing. If India is, apart from Maldives, recently, our Indian Prime Minister, he had gone just recently, last week, he had gone to some foreign countries.
Yes, sir.
How many foreign countries you visited?
Sir, one is Palestine. design and
then he went to a place and he inaugurated the first major grand Hindu temple in a particular place. In that country they did not have a grand temple till that day. Abu Dhabi?
Yes, yes sir.
And then he went to Oman.
Yes,
so basically the Middle Eastern
Middle East countries.
Okay. So can you tell me what is the significance of this visit and how India is going to gain from this visit?
Sir, main purpose of this visit is to strong economic relation and business development, sir.
Okay. Any major treaties which were signed in this visit, if you can tell me, one or two treaties.
Sorry, sir.
Okay. Unable to recall, no? Okay. Fine. So, coming to Odisha, can you tell me any two important news from Odisha? In a particular assembly constituency, there will be by-election.
Yes, sir.
Which place is that?
It is in Baragarh district, sir. It is Vijaypur, sir.
Why there is a by-election? What happened?
Sir, previous MLA had passed away and now campaigning is going on for by-election, sir.
What is, according to the constitution, what is the rule if a post or MLA or MP passes away? Within what time that particular vacancy has to be filled up?
Sir, it is within 6 months, sir.
Within 6 months, sir?
Yes, sir.
Okay. So, what are the optionals you have taken in this exam?
Sir, in my mains exam, I have opted forestry and public administration, sir.
Forestry and public administration?
Yes, sir.
Tell me, according to you, I'll tell you three qualities of a civil servant. According to you, which is the most important quality and why, you have to explain, okay?
Yes, sir.
Number one is honesty, second is efficiency, third is sincerity. Honesty, efficiency, sincerity.
Yes,
which one is the most important quality according to you? One.
Sir, a civil servant must have all these qualities for better service of the community, but efficiency is very much required for a civil servant to handle the situation as well as public.
Okay, efficiency, okay, fine. So suppose there is one officer, he is very efficient, he will deliver whatever this task is given to him, he will deliver it, he will do it. Okay, but he may not be very honest. Okay. So suppose his integrity is a little bit doubtful, he's not honest, okay,
sir.
Maybe he is, you know, keeping some percentage or commission from the public money, but he will do the work on time, he will, delivery of service will be there,
sir.
This is officer 1. Officer 2 is highly honest,
yes, sir.
And very sincere also, he tries to do the work. But since he is very honest, he does not, whatever is written in the book, he will go by that. He does not compromise on anything.
Sir.
As a result, he is unable to deliver in most of the times.
Sir.
Okay, because if the thing is not done according to the book, he will not allow anything to be done.
Sir.
So from these two officers, from a point of view of public administration, which of these two officers are more desirable in a public service?
Sir, according to me, sir, combination of these two officers is beneficial for development of our...
No, that is again hybrid answer. You have only one choice. Keep, okay?
Sir.
One officer only. Right?
Sir.
Only one can be taken, not two. So now tell me.
Sir, second one is...
More honest or more efficient? Which one? Which officer? Honest officer?
More honest, sir.
More honest?
Yes, sir.
But no work will be done? Okay. Have you heard this particular saying that the straight trees are cut first? The straight trees are cut first.
Sir.
So, who said that? Do you know? No idea?
No, sir.
That is in Chanakya Niti, Chanakya has said that the straight trees are cut first. Okay, that means you know when these loggers, the woodcutters, they will go to the forest. So if they see a tree is like, you know, it is not straight, they will not cut it because it is more difficult to cut. If they see a straight tree, they will cut it first. So the straight trees are cut first. So that means that people who are very straight and you know, simple, straightforward generally. That is the reason I said that honesty, that is fine, but delivery of services, okay, may be most important for the people. Okay. Anyway, so are you aware, have you ever heard the term string of pearls? String of pearls related to international affairs, no?
No, sir.
Okay, string of pearls, okay, just it's a kind of a military strategy of China to have various economic routes, okay, so that if during war or any emergency some routes are blocked, its economy will not be affected.
Sir,
it's not necessarily India specific thing, but you have to see. Okay, so what is the internationally, there is a huge problem going on now between North Korea and America. Are you aware of it? What is the problem between North Korea and America?
Sir, it is the nuclear issue, sir. North Korea is always trying to dominate the world by its nuclear weapons, frequently testing for nuclear weapons.
So what is the relation between North Korea and India? Is there any direct diplomatic relation between North Korea and India? What is the equation between North Korea and India? Are you aware of that?
No, sir.
Okay. So who is our current defense minister?
Sir, our current defense minister is Nirmala Sitharaman.
Is she the first woman defense minister of India?
Yes, sir. She is the first full-time
woman defense minister.
Woman defense minister.
What do you mean by full-time? There was some other part-time minister or what?
Sir, before she, Indira Gandhi was defense minister along with prime minister, sir.
Oh, she had also kept the...
Yes, sir.
Post of that is why you are saying she is the first full time.
Yes, sir.
Okay, okay. And can you tell me latest news on some defense acquisition? What defense deals we have just signed recently? There is a UN prime political circles regarding a deal called Rafale. Can you tell me about the Rafale deal? What is Rafale? It's a submarine.
Yes, no, sir.
Huh?
It is a fighter jet, sir.
It's a fighter jet. From which country?
It is from France, sir.
And do you know the manufacturer? Who will manufacture it? The company that manufactures it?
No, sir.
Okay. What is the problem? Why there is a political storm about it?
Because it is in news for price, sir. It is little bit higher than desired by the India.
Okay.
And India is demanding for two-seater fighter jet, but Rafale is till now it is one-seater, sir, and so it must be two-seater for India.
Okay. There is how many aircraft carriers are now functional in India? Indian Navy has how many aircraft carriers now? Right. So, your home district is, which district is your home district?
Sir, Mayurbhanj.
Mayurbhanj.
Yes, sir.
Okay. So, just name two famous persons from Mayurbhanj in the field of literature, art, literature, writers, etc.
Sir, Jatin Das, one of the painter.
Okay.
He is famous for painting.
And second person?
In film industry, Nandita Das, daughter of Jatin Das, she is also famous, sir.
Okay, okay. And in Mayurbhanj, basically, what is the number, you know, district wise,
yes, sir,
in terms of area? In terms of area?
Area. It is the largest in area, sir.
It is the largest in area. And in population?
It is number in third in population, sir, after Ganjam and Cuttack.
After Ganjam and Cuttack?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Okay, so that will be the end of the interview. Thank you.
Thank you, sir.